Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will look at one of the specialized tree structure, AVL tree. AVL tree is a self-balancing binary search tree in which height of the left subtree and height of the right subtree is very important. That is, every node should have the balancing factor. How do we calculate the balancing factor? Balancing factor is the height of the left subtree minus the height of the right subtree. Every node has to have this balancing factor. Now the value of the balancing factor can either be minus 1, plus 1 or 0. These three values are only allowed in the case of AVL tree. Node doesn't follow this of the values, that is minus 1, 1 or 0. In that case, we need to perform the rotations. There are four types of rotation. These are LL rotation, that is left-left, RR, right-right rotation, left-right rotation and right-left rotation. Based on this, we are going to adjust the tree in such a pattern that every node has a balancing factor of minus 1, 1 or 0. Let us begin with the topic. I have defined a class called as AVL node. Inside that I have two reference variables, left and right, of the class AVL node. Then we have data and height variable. Then we go for the constructor of the AVL node. How do you understand it is a constructor? By checking the name of the function and the class name. Through this constructor we are going to pass the values. These are, left is going to be null, right is going to be null, data is going to be 0 and height is also going to be 0. Height is always going to be calculating through the left minus right. You must remember, we first have the left hand subtree minus right hand subtree. Once this is done, then we have parameterized constructor in which we are going to pass the value through the n variable. Now the value of n is taken from the user. We write down left equal to null, right equal to null, data equal to n, that is the n value which the user wants to have is to be passed to the data, and height is for the starting point, it is going to be 0. These are the four reference variables which you need to have: left, right, data and height. These are going to have the structure of the AVL tree. These are very important from point of view of having the values of the balancing factor. Once this is done, then we have the class AVL tree. Inside that we have the reference variable of the class AVL node. Then we are going to call the constructor AVL tree, in which we are going to pass the value of the root equal to null. So for the starting point, we are going to pass the value of root as null. Then we are going to call the functions. First function is to check whether the tree is empty. For this we have public boolean is empty. This is the function which we are going to define so that the root is calculated. If it is so, that if it is empty, in that case what you're going to return is the root value. Now in case of this, if the tree is empty, in that case root will be equal to null. Hence you're going to return root equal to null. Then we may take the logically empty. That is, we have to make sure the tree is logically empty. That is, we need to have the function public void make empty. How do you understand that the tree is empty? By checking the value of root. So we purposely have the value of root equal to null. So by make empty, we are going to make sure root equal to null. Once that is done, then every other node is not relevant for the tree. Once we are done with the definition of the tree structure, AVL tree, then we are going to have the function to insert the data into the AVL tree. Now it is very important to understand, for every node, balancing factor has to be calculated. Balancing factor is height of left subtree minus the height of right subtree. Now this value of the balancing factor for every node has to be minus 1, plus 1 or 0. It can have either of this value. If it doesn't have this value, then we will go for the rotation. There are four types of rotation which we have discussed earlier. We write down the function public void insert and we pass the value of data. For root is to be called, that is root equal to insert data comma root, that is data value will be passed through the root. Then we will have the height of the tree. We have private int height AVL node value reference variable t. Then we return the value of tree, that is return t equal to null. If it is true, that is t is equal to null, in that case we have the value as minus 1. If not, That is false. That is, the t is not equal to null. In that case, we have t dot height value. That is, t dot height will be calculated and given back to the t. Then we have the function to have the maximum of left and right node. It is always important to calculate the value of maximum of left and right. We write down private int max left hand side and right hand side. Then we return the value of left hand side is greater than the right hand side. In that case, we have the value of left hand side. If it is less, then we have right hand side. This is how you insert the data into the given AVL tree. Now we will look at the insert function, which we need to define so that the value is inserted in such a pattern that the balancing factor of every node is either minus 1, plus 1 or 0. We have private AVL node insert x comma AVL node t. We are going to check if t equal to equal to null. In that case, AVL node value would be value of x. X value will be given to the t object. If not, then we are going to check else if x is less than t dot data, that the value user wants to insert is less than the given data value. In that case, we need to the move to the left hand side. We write down t dot left equal to insert x comma t dot left. Then we will check the balancing factor for each and every node. That is, if height of left subtree minus height of right subtree is equal to equal to 2, in that case we are going to adjust. That is, if x is less than t dot left dot data, then if it is so, that is, x is less than t left data, in that case we will rotate with the left child. Hence we write down t equal to rotate with the left child function will be cast through the value of t. If not, then we need to double shift it. That is, else t equal to double with left child, and inside that we have the parameter t. If this is not the condition, that is, else if x is less than t dot data is not there, what does it mean? We will go for the another set of condition in which we are going to check whether x is greater than t dot data. Else if x is greater than t dot data, in that case we are going to have the same set of values. That is, instead of left, we are going to write down right. That is, t dot right equal to insert x comma t dot right instead of t dot left. We are going to write t dot right equal to insert x comma t dot right instead of t dot left. Then we are going to check with the height. If height of t dot right minus height of t dot left is equal to 2. Since we are dealing with the greater sign, we have, if height of t dot right is greater than the height of left value equal to 2, in that case we are going to check if x is greater than t dot right dot data. That is very important. Now in case of right, we are going to check if x is greater than t dot right dot data. If it is so, then the value of t will be calling the function rotate with the right child through the value t. Else double rotate with the right child. We write down t equal to double with right child through the value of t. This is done. That is, we are done with the less than value. Then we are done with the greater than value. Then we will check with the else part. That is, whether it is same case where we have duplicate values. We write down else t dot height will be calculated. Maximum of left value, that is, t dot height equal to maximum height of t dot left comma height of t dot right plus 1. This is going to be taken the value. If it is so, then return the value of t. That is, going to check the values of each and every node. The balancing factor of each and every node needs to be calculated, whether it is minus 1, plus 1 or 0. This is how you insert the value into the given AVL tree. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to EKD channel.